New findings show women with early-stage breast cancer can avoid chemotherapy. The question of whether to be treated with chemotherapy is a key question women face after surgery and hormone treatment. Researchers now say most women with smaller tumors can safely skip chemo and avoid its side effects, such as fatigue and nausea. The findings may change clinical practice for as many as 70,000 women a year in the U.S. Dr. Larry Norton is a leading breast cancer specialist and senior vice president of Memorial Sloan Kettering Cancer Center, which participated in the study. Dr. Norton, thank you for your time. Can you just tell us, big picture, off the bat now, why is this such an important breakthrough?
Well, now we know that we can identify patients who have a very good prognosis and don't need chemotherapy. So these patients will be spared chemotherapy. That's a wonderful, wonderful result.
And you're able to know this now because of a gene test. You can kind of assess people's risks. And you're talking about women with what you call intermediate risk. Explain to me what that means.
Yeah, well, we do this test of 21 genes. It's called the Oncotype DX test. And it tells us a scale from 0 to 100, which relates to the risk of the cancer spreading to another part of the body. Very low scores, up to 10. It's a very low chance if these patients get hormone therapy, and chemotherapy doesn't help them. We've known that for a long time. Very high scores are at increased risk of the cancer spreading, and those patients have benefited a lot by chemotherapy, and we've known that also. But the intermediate patients with scores of 11 to 25, we've not known what's best for them. Should we give them chemotherapy? Should we not give them chemotherapy? What is the best option for these individuals? We haven't had guidance. Now we do. This very large, very important study is telling us that people with those intermediate scores have a very good prognosis, and that prognosis is not improved by chemotherapy. So they don't have to receive chemotherapy. And that's just a wonderful thing to look somebody in the eye and say, you've got a great prognosis, your odds of being cured are terrific, and you don't need chemotherapy because you don't need it. You've got a great prognosis and the chemotherapy won't help. It's a wonderful thing to be able to look somebody in the eye and give them that information.
Dr. Norton, help me understand, for all the women who have been following standard practice up until now and were receiving chemotherapy, who you now say wouldn't have needed it, was there a risk associated with being overtreated?
Well, I mean, it depends on the chemotherapy they received. With some chemotherapies, there is a slightly increased risk of some bad effects. With other chemotherapies, such as the one we've been using at Memorial Sloan Kettering, which is the CMF combination, there's no evidence of long-term toxicity, so that there's some variation in that regard. But the risks are very small. The long-term risks are very small. And the people that I've spoken to who, in this trial, randomized to get chemotherapy, are feeling good about these results because they had the chemotherapy, they're disease-free, it hasn't hurt them, but they've helped thousands and thousands of other women, maybe 100,000 women per year in the United States alone are going to benefit from these results. And people are very altruistic. The volunteers to this trial are altruists. They're real heroes, and they've made a massive contribution to helping people with cancer throughout the world.
Dr. Larry Norton, thanks for your time.
My pleasure. Thank you.